could see I have an example where I have a ball joint. So I can move this top component wherever I'd like. And at any moment in time, I could choose to hit this gray button, this revert icon. And when I do, it's simply going to go back to the original position. So that off the bat should help you. Because if you're designing something and you put it in a different position and you don't want to have to figure out how to get it back into the original, the answer is very simple. All you have to do is click on this revert button and it'll automatically move your component back to the original position. Now let's say you do want to capture the position in a new orientation. All you have to do is move the component, and you could do that manually by clicking and dragging on the component just like I did there. And then you get to choose to capture the position. When you do that, you're going to get an icon right here down below on your timeline. And what that's going to do is it's going to capture that at this moment in time, this object, this orange ball, or rather this orange component that has a ball on it, of course, is now in this position. And if I move it to another position and then hit the capture button again, now it's capturing that the second point in time is going to be this particular position. Now, why does this matter, right? It matters for a variety of different reasons. Maybe you're designing some sort of assembly and you want to be able to capture like an image of this particular assembly through, you know, three different points in time, like three different positions of the components. Well, in this particular case, all I have to do is go back in my timeline one step, and I get the position when it was at position 12 here. And I do that one more time and I get the original position. So this is a great way to be able to capture, you know, different movements of the assembly, or at least different points in time in the assembly.